Hello everyone, welcome back to another video. It is Francesco here. Welcome to Keep Productive YouTube channel if you're brand new, but if you're a regular, welcome back. So guys, today's video I'm going to be diving into Missive, which is an email application. You guys have been pushing me towards reviewing this one, and I've been noted that I did miss it in my 30 plus Newton Alternatives video, so I do apologize. I mainly did think it was a team application, and in my head, I didn't think it had a personal version of it. So I'm gonna give you my first impressions, diving into what I think of the application, and hopefully giving you a nice overview of the resource. So big thanks to Z Kane, who did shout this one out to me and push me towards reviewing it, because I have been quite impressed with it. Without further ado, guys, let's dive into Missive. So here we are on Missive, and many of you guys have obviously been messaging me about this one. I initially did think it was a team application, like many of the others, like Front Zendesk have got one of these, and I genuinely did think it was. What I want to do today is run through some of the structural functions and also some of the features that this application has. So one of the first things you can do is, of course, connect up your accounts. Accounts can be accessed in the bottom right left-hand corner. This application allows you to connect with many different accounts. You can connect with Gmail, G Suite, Office 365, Outlook, iCloud, IMAP, and in some of the premium functions, Twilio SMS, Messenger, and Twitter. And I can explain the pricing nearer the end. So actually, first sort of day using this application, I have been fairly impressed with it. Let's just take myself off settings. It is available on a fair amount of platforms, Windows, macOS, iOS, and Google Play. The main ones, which I didn't actually know, I thought it was just on Mac and iOS, but actually it's quite widely available. You can also get the web app as well, which is available through all browsers. So that does make it more accessible. It's probably the most accessible applications out there. So it does definitely put it as a contender in that Newton lineup. Again, this is my first impressions, so I'm just going to run through some of the things that stood out to me. So of course, the experiences are more collaborative. So when you, for example, when you create a new email and you have an organization set up in this, you can use this window here to essentially create a draft email, give each other assignments. So essentially like assign other people activities or tasks to do. And you can even label features and write the full piece out. So that's great if you want to connect with your team email. And it does ask you when you get started, whether you want specifically to have an organization set up. So you can go to organizations and create a new organization. So if I put sample, you can add all the email addresses that are relevant to it. So you can create many different organizations, but of course that falls under a different plan, which we'll go near it in the end. So this is what it looks like as a personal setup. Down the left-hand side, you've got inbox. The blues are indicated of unseen conversations and 28 full conversations. Now on the free, you only get 15 days of your account unlocked. So you can only see the last 15 days of your messages or emails, which is quite limiting. Now, one thing I was quite impressed with is this application does have trackable read receipts. So once you press that, you send an email through your account. So you, of course, can see whether the person has read the email, which is quite an attractive function and something that is locked a lot of time under premium. So that's a definite bonus. Over here, they've got the same send later that is available through Spark and many of the other email applications. You can also get follow-up reminders as well. So let's say you send one message and you're like, okay, I need to check. So you're essentially snoozing it if no one replies until a certain day. Now, snoozing is available through the application as well as undo send, which is a fairly impressive one. You do get rules as well, which is quite impressive. Again, there is plenty more functions. So if you go over to the left-hand panel, you can see rules and responses, and you could even sort of preference the gestures that you do have when you swipe across stuff. So that's just how it looks as you swipe across per email. So it's quite easy to use. It works pretty much the same way as a sort of application. What I particularly like is the design. It does look like the closest thing to Newton in terms of design. I love this little icon here that it picks out. picks out some of your icons, and of course, you can see all of the regular information that you do. Everything does look fairly snappy. One thing I would say is it's a hair or two faster than Spark when you're opening up an email here. You can do all the regular stuff like reply, snooze, archive, trash, and there's a whole host of settings here. I would say the design, mainly because it looks more like Newton, is more attractive through this application than the likes of Spark. Although, again, Spark functionally looks fantastic. So, of course, I'll be trying out this application in the same fashion as I am with Astro and Spark. So, as you can imagine, this application is a paid application, technically. So you do have, as I was mentioning, 15 days free with the application, which I think, you know, if you're only sending emails, you can only get 15 days. This is up to you get. So today is the 4th, and I'm getting all the way till August 20th. And that is the same for search too. So once you search something, it will only bring up relevant to those times. It obviously, you get 5 shared accounts email inside the free account. So for example, I could add 5 more accounts to this, and it wouldn't affect the freemium. There is a $8 per month starter pack, which is, again, about £5 UK. I think that's fairly reasonable. You get 6 months of history, which is essentially your search on emails. So if you're a big search on emails, you know, that might not even do you. $12 per month for the professional package is unlimited emails access. Now, you do get a 30-day free trial with this application, so I do recommend playing around with it before you necessarily commit. And there are a whole host of different sort of functions that you can use it with. As I said, I think it's definitely more of a tool for emailing with teams than it is necessarily a tool for personal email. Although you can use it, it's just more of a paid resource. So the other addition is that all paid plans include an unlimited amount of personal email, Facebook, and Twilio SMS access, but the Twitter account is the exemption. All accounts are charged at $20 per month. So you can have the SMS, you can have Messenger and Twitter run through this application. Now, what I would say is it's attractive and the closest visual to Newton, but I would say that it's definitely much more designed for teams. The real functionality comes out there. Anyway, guys, hopefully you enjoyed this review. This, again, is a first impressions feature. So do let me know in the comments whether you're using Missive. It'd be great to hear. Of course, I'll be back with a full review, and I'm planning to review Spark as well soon, as well as Astro and a couple more email apps. But again, this is one that you guys really pushed down my sort of avenue. So many thanks, and I look forward to checking out in more detail as I go in through the first few weeks. Anyway, guys, big thanks for stopping by. Make sure to hit that subscription button and have a great week. If you liked the video, hit the like button too. Anyway, guys, make sure to have a great week. Keep productive, and I'll see you guys very, very soon. Cheers.